So first of all, let me present you the definition of nature-based solutions. So nature-based solutions are solutions which are inspired and supported by nature. They are cost-effective and simultaneously provide environmental, social, and economic benefits and help build resilience. Such solutions bring more and more diverse natural features and processes into the city. Landscapes, seascapes through locally adapted, resource-efficient and systemic interventions. Local and regional governments can use nature-based solutions to mitigate, absorb, and prevent risks associated with different hazards and to strengthen resilience. At the same time, these nature-based tools can contribute to protecting, recovering, and strengthening their respective ecosystems. Planners can use different innovative planning and design strategies, including nature-based solutions, looking at the morphology of a city, its geography, environment in which it was built on, and its memory of place. Planners can also draft special building codes, regulations to increase climate resilience of housing and public facilities, and thus facilitating the integration of these nature-based solutions at a micro scale and improving the quality of life of a city as a whole. At a macro scale, so main elements of landscape at a neighborhood, city, and regional levels, for example, water access, parks, green corridors, provide a base from which it is possible to renature a city and incorporate green and blue infrastructures into the city's strategic planning. So green infrastructure, this is a strategically planned network of natural and semi-natural areas with other environmental features designed and managed so as to deliver a wide range of ecosystem services. Renaturalization of urban fabric is one of the nature-based solutions most easily leveraged by local and regional governments, for example, to mitigate pollution levels. What usually local and regional governments do to build green infrastructure? This is planting trees in streets and public areas, creating public urban garden areas, green roofs on buildings with orchard, vegetation gardens, etc., installing vertical gardens on facades, and soil drainage. So green infrastructures, it should be noted, must ensure that the plant species are well adapted to the territory, are native, and resistant to possible local conditions, for example, wind, snow, etc. So local and regional governments can ensure that environmental corridors are connected as much as possible rather than being fragmented by road infrastructure. For example, so green bridges can be used as biodiversity corridors. Nature-based phyto remediation is also part of green infrastructure, and so it helps to clean the contaminated land, air, enhance air quality, public health. Also, these nature-based solutions can contribute to improving neighborhood aesthetics, improved natural ventilation, and shading of public spaces. Next slide, please. As an example, we can see the Park Lineal Las Vegas in the city of Puerto Viejo, Ecuador. So in 2016, there was an earthquake, and before the earthquake, the areas around the Puerto Viejo River were abandoned and faced degradation. And the governments implemented within 3 years implemented the project aimed at the integration of ecosystem-based adaptation into city park systems. So this Las Vegas Linear Park project includes reconstruction and economic reactivation of a city, flood risk reduction, environmental recovery, and creation of public spaces. So it also incorporates ecosystem-based climate change adaptation solutions. What has been done? First of all, riverbanks were reclaimed and reused as recreational zones. Abandoned streams were regenerated and converted into wetlands. So wetlands also were used as stormwater retention tanks, and flora and fauna increased. So now park is a recreational and cultural space. Next slide, please. Blue infrastructure. So this relates to nature-based solutions and green infrastructure and incorporate aquatic ecosystems, rivers, wetlands, coastal and marine areas. So most cities have developed throughout history in locations which are very close to water. And high water dependency is due to human consumption, drinking water and also provision of sewerage and sanitation services, mobilization, transportation, and others. And so the effects of climate change and environmental pollution are leading cities to rethink their relationship with the water cycle. Producing and consuming municipalities have a role in preventing the degradation of their aquifers by coordinating strategies and improving management. So examples of this approach is so modernizing rainwater and greywater drainage system and network to prevent leakages, rainwater harvesting, greywater reuse, aquifer recharge at the catchment level, raise public awareness of responsible water consumption, ensure that water catchments are in optimal sanitary conditions. All of these solutions can benefit from the enormous potential of nature-based solutions. Local and regional governments are being challenged to take an integrated water supply and sanitation management, since water resources, ecosystems, and their cycles have become increasingly valuable and vulnerable. Next slide, please. Examples. So first of all, I would like to mention the city of Manila, so the Philippines. There was implemented the project aimed at restoration of the Pasig River. Project builds on the values of blue infrastructure. So the project ran from 2012 to 2015. A hyper-degraded and littered river was transformed into a new landscape asset with plants and crystal clean waters. So what has been done? So water treatment plant was constructed, robust solid waste management was carried out, and participation of the community. So community was involved. Next example is Seoul, South Korea, restoration of Cheonggyecheon River. Maybe I have mispronounced. So this river was covered by a highway for decades, and project raised awareness about the role urban planning should play in central areas of the city and in changing the model of private mobility towards the use of public transport. What were benefits? So reduced the heat island effect and air pollution. Next example, Cologne, Germany, Rhine River. So the problem was increased frequency of flooding. What was the solution? So a hydraulic wall was installed to protect the old city center, which contains the city's key heritage for tourism. And so retention areas were created, river banks were natured, and new construction was prohibited in that area. So these are the main points concerning nature-based solutions. Now we can pass on to the dynamic.